We're focusing on an example of solution stoichiometry. So our example states, according to the label on a bottle of concentrated hydrochloric acid, the contents are 36% HCl by mass and have a density of 1.18 grams per milliliter. We're asked three different questions here. Our first one is, what is the molarity of the concentrated HCl? So let's start off with that one. Identify what we're given and what we're finding as always. So we're given 36% of HCl by mass. Now, whenever you see this percentage by mass, that's gonna act as your conversion factor. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna split this apart and 36 grams of HCl will go on top. And then on the bottom would be 100 grams of HCl solution. Next, we're also given our density of 1.18 grams per milliliter, and this is specifically of the HCl solution. Next, we're asked to find the molarity, and remember, molarity is moles divided by liters. So some way, somehow, we're gonna get to moles of HCl and divide that by the liters of our HCl solution. So what we're gonna do first is, taking that 36 grams per every 100 gram of HCl solution, we're gonna put that and multiply that by the density that was provided, because our grams of HCl and grams of HCl solution are going to then cancel. And then now we have grams of HCl divided by the milliliters of our HCl solution. And then so we're at this current step right now. After we've multiplied already, we have to keep going, because remember, we're trying to find the molarity. So that means we want our moles of HCl on top divided by liters of our HCl solution. So taking what we just found, that 0.4248 grams of HCl, then I'm gonna change this to moles using the molar mass of HCl. So aligning our grams of HCl, and remember, grams of HCl, how we find that, how we found the molar mass, is just taking our mass of each individual element. We have hydrogen that has 1.01, chlorine, which has 35.45, and we're gonna add those two together to get our molar mass of HCl, which would be 36.46 grams per mole. So I'm gonna put the grams on the bottom and the moles on top, since we're trying to find moles on top. And then from here, our grams of HCl and grams of HCl will then cancel. And then now we have moles of HCl on top and milliliters on the bottom, so we're almost done. The next portion here is to change milliliters on the bottom to liters. So what we're gonna use is 1,000 milliliters. Put that on top so our units would then cancel. And we always want those units across from each other so they can cancel. And then next, our liters of HCl is finally on the bottom. So what we're gonna see is we're finally gonna have our unit of moles of HCl divided by the liters of our HCl solution. And then from there, our final answer would give us 11.7 molarity of our HCl solution. So that's the molarity of HCl. Let's move on to part B. Part B states, what volume of it would you need to prepare 283 milliliters of a 2.20 molar solution of HCl? So we're gonna use our previous portion, our previous molarity in part A that we found, which was that 11.7 molarity of HCl. So that is gonna be our given, one of our givens in this question. Now, we're asked to find another volume. So what I want you to notice is the fact that we started off, or in part A, we had 11.7 molarity of HCl, but this time we decreased our molarity. So anytime we're decreasing that molarity and we're dealing with molarity and volume, that's a dilution. So we have to use our dilution formula of M1 V1, those two are multiplied, and set that equal to M2 times V2. Let's identify what our M1 and V1 and M2 and V2 are. So our M1 is gonna be what we found initially, what we found in part A. And then what we're given our molarity to is that 2.20 molarity of HCl. Next, we're asked what volume of it, meaning what volume of our previous molarity, so our initial molarity. So we're finding V1. and they give us V2 is 283 milliliters. Okay, now that we've identified everything here, let's just plug in. So we'll plug in 11.7 for our M1, and then V1, remember that's what we're solving for, and then M2, we'll plug in 2.20, and V2, we'll plug in 283, and then from there, all we have to do is to get V1 by itself, so we'll divide over that 11.7 to either side, and then from there, these two would cancel. We'll solve for V1 after we do the math, so multiply the numerator first, what's on top, and divide it by 11.7. We would get 53.2 milliliters of HCl. One more question, let's go to part C. Part C states, what mass of sodium bicarbonate would be needed to neutralize the spill if a bottle containing 1.75 liters of concentrated HCl dropped on a lab floor and broke open? So once again, let's identify, what are we given? What are we finding? So we're given that 1.75 liters of HCl. And then remember, we're still gonna use our concentrated HCl molarity that we found in part A, which was that 11.7 molarity of HCl. Now we're asked to find grams of a completely different compound, and in this case, it's sodium bicarbonate. So we're gonna do a little bit of stoichiometry here. So before I move on to stoichiometry, one thing to note is we need our balanced equation. Because we're going from moles, or really a one compound of HCl, to a totally different compound of sodium bicarbonate, we have to do a multiple ratio. And where do we get a multiple ratio? Our balanced equation, those coefficients in front. So our balanced equation would be HCl plus sodium bicarbonate. And what's gonna happen is that sodium, or Na, would then combine with Cl. So we'll see that here. These two would combine to form that NaCl. And then the next portion here is a little bit different because we're gonna form two additional products. And this is from that hydrogen combining with that bicarbonate portion. So when hydrogen gets combined with bicarbonate, it forms water and carbon dioxide. Okay. Now, if we were to add everything up, we'll see that this is already balanced, how nice. So everything has a one, every single compound has a one in front, so it's all a one-to-one relationship. Now, let's start this problem off with our given. So our given was that 1.75 liters of HCl. Remember, molarity is usually used as a conversion factor, which is exactly what we're gonna use it for this question. Now we're gonna have 1.75 liters of HCl, align our units so they can cancel, so 1 liter of HCl. And where I'm taking this, by the way, I can rewrite this as 11.7 moles of HCl divided by 1 liter of HCl. So that's what you wanna do whenever you're looking at molarity, split it apart into moles divided by liters. Now we're at moles of HCl on top, and then I want those moles of HCl to cancel to then get to moles of a completely different compound, or moles really of our sodium bicarbonate. So this is where our balanced equation will come in. We're gonna do a multiple ratio again, and then remember everything had a one in front of the compound, so I'm just gonna do 1 mole of HCl. On top would be 1 mole of sodium bicarbonate, so moles of HCl would then cancel. And then finally, we're asked to find the grams of sodium bicarbonate. So we need to use the molar mass of sodium bicarbonate. That's what we're gonna calculate right now. So sodium has a mass of 22.99, hydrogen has a mass of 1.01, carbon 12.01, and oxygen is 16. However, there are 3 oxygen within this compound. So I'm gonna multiply that by 3 and we'll get 48. Now we'll add everything together. So adding all of these masses that we found together, we will get the molar mass of 84.01 grams per mole, which we have to place on top. Since we're looking for grams, that's why we're placing grams on top. And then remember, we want our units to cancel. So moles of sodium bicarbonate, let's align those across from each other so they can cancel. And finally, we have our grams of sodium bicarbonate. multiply straight across, since really we're dividing by one, and then from here our answer would be 1,720 grams of sodium bicarbonate. And that was our packed example of a solution stoichiometry question. If this video helped you out, make sure to like and subscribe. And for more resources that can help you with either molarity or stoichiometry or really chemistry in general, make sure to check out the description box and keep practicing, guys. Keep going. You are absolutely capable. I'll see you in the next video.